Yo, Mr. Imob, my name is Rayo, and this video is designed in a specific way that by the end of the video, you can start your first stream on Twitch. First thing you need for streaming is a streaming software. And while technically you do have two options there, then in reality, you really have just one option, and that is OBS Studio. So make sure you download OBS Studio. Link is in the description as well. Now that you've downloaded and installed OBS Studio, just open it and it should look a little bit something like this. Currently, there's nothing here, but we're gonna add a bunch of nice things here. So first of all, let's go down to the left here, and here we can see scenes. A scene is basically everything on your stream that the viewer is going to see. You can have a bunch of scenes and you can change between them. So first, we're gonna start with the most basic scene that's going to show everything that's going on your screen. And for this, let's go to the down left corner here, click on the plus icon, add a scene. This is gonna be a desktop scene. You can rename it to whatever you want. And then we have a scene. Make sure this is selected. Go down to the right side to sources, and again, click on the plus sign. Now we're going to add your main screen, and for this, let's choose display capture. This is going to obviously capture your display. Just press OK here. And here, if you have multiple displays, make sure you select the correct one and then press OK. There we go. Our viewers can now see our screen. The infinity effect you're currently seeing here is a little bit annoying, right? I know, but it's OK. Don't worry about it. So now that we can actually see the display, we need to hear it as well. And for this, we're gonna go down to the plus icon as well in the sources and add audio output capture. So this is going to capture your system sounds. Press OK. And here, either just leave it on default or choose whichever device you're using. And again, press OK. And now you can actually see in Audio Mixer, we have an audio output capture. So we're gonna take a closer look at this after we have added a microphone. With microphone, it's the same thing again. Go to the plus icon, but this time choose audio input capture. This will be your microphone. Press OK and choose your microphone. For me, it's Razer Cyber Mini. Super nice microphone, by the way. Super cheap, super nice quality. I've been thinking about doing a review about this because for small streamers and content creators like you and me probably, it is so good, trust me. Anyways, let's continue on. Press OK. And now we also have audio input capture. And now you can see that I can adjust the volume with this light bar here. And basically what you want to do, let me take my microphone here. Whoop. It actually just dislodged. Okay, so now you can see my microphone. It's going currently a little bit in the red, so I'm gonna move the slide bar a little bit lower. So it's mostly in the yellows. So make sure your voice is mostly in the yellows. And you can just leave it at that for now. Okay, you can go back now. And now the next thing, if you don't have a webcam, you can obviously skip this one. But if you do, then go again to the plus icon and add a video capture device. Press OK and choose your webcam. As you can see, hey, this is me. There are a bunch of settings you can change here. I would recommend you choose custom resolution and FPS type. And then don't go too big with the resolution because you really need maybe maximum 1280 by 720 when you're using a webcam, because it's gonna be really small in the corner here anyways. There's no need to use the full resolution. It's only gonna eat up more of your PC resources if you have a higher resolution, and we don't want that to happen. So let's take 720p. FPS is gonna be always match output FPS. And for now, that's perfectly good enough. So let's press OK. And now we can move this webcam. We can adjust the size. We can even hold down Alt key. And while pressing mouse 1, we can drag this slider here and crop in the webcam on all the sides. So there's a lot of customizability you can do. And now, as you can see, within a couple of minutes, we are pretty much ready to go live, except we still have a couple things to do, which I'm gonna show you right now. So go to settings down in the right corner, go to the stream tab, and because we're going to be streaming on Twitch, then just click connect account. So this window is gonna pop up. We can accept the cookies, why not? So just log in, and then we have this OBS Studio software connected with our Twitch account, which means that whenever we press the start streaming button down in the corner here, it's already going to be broadcasting everything on our Twitch channel. So now that we're actually able to start our stream, we should also figure out the best video settings for our stream so that both you and your viewers get the best experience possible. This is really advanced stuff, but we'll make it super simple for now. I'm gonna make much more in-depth videos in the future about them, so make sure you subscribe to my channel, like this video as well, so more people who need to see this video can see it. And let's just continue on. Go to the output tab on your settings, and here, as an encoder, if you have NVIDIA NVENC, then make sure you choose this. This simply means that your PC is gonna use your GPU instead of your CPU for encoding, and it's gonna leave a lot more resources for other stuff. Best example being gaming. And basically it's gonna save a lot of resources and you're gonna get much more stable and better FPS in games, and your stream is gonna look more stable as well. If you don't have NVIDIA NVENC, then X264 is totally fine as well. Now the next big question is, which bitrate are we going to use? Well, first start testing your streams with 4000 or 4500 bitrate. The maximum bitrate Twitch allows is 6000, and the more bitrate you have, the better the stream quality is. But also remember that the higher the bitrate, the more resources your PC is going to need. So if you don't have a very powerful, super expensive PC, then just stay away from 6000 bitrate. Stick to 4500. Otherwise, what's gonna happen is your stream is gonna look very laggy and choppy and nobody's gonna enjoy it. So here the key thing is to remember that Twitch is all about testing, testing, testing. So test different bit rates, which one fits the best for you and your PC. You can go down as low as 3000, 3500 maybe. If you can't use a high bit rate, then don't panic, it's really not that big of a deal. Your stream is still gonna look perfectly fine. Okay, that's settled. Next thing, video. Go down to the video tab. And here the base resolution is obviously gonna be your main screen. For me, it's 2K resolution. For you, it can be 4K or 1080. But the important part here is the output resolution. And listen carefully here. Never ever fall into the trap of using 1920 by 1080. I know it's gonna be really tempting to stream with as high of a resolution as possible, but just don't do that. It's not good for anyone. Your stream is not gonna look good at all, because it's just gonna take so much performance from your PC to process all those pixels. And even more so if you're planning to play some FPS games, then it's gonna start looking really pixelated all the time. My favorite resolution, as you can see, is 1600 by 900. You can also go down to 1280 by 720. It's perfectly fine. It's gonna be good enough of a quality. And now FPS, obviously, if you want to start streaming video games, then go 60 FPS. But if you're only doing just chatting, meaning that it's only gonna be you, your face and your audience, and there's no video games, there's no fast moving on the screen, then 30 FPS is absolutely okay and will save you a lot of resources. Again, if you're testing 60 FPS, but your stream is becoming laggy or choppy or pixelated, then switch down to 30 FPS. It's totally fine. Again, streaming is all about testing, 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 so don't worry about it. But now, make sure you press apply as well, press OK, and believe it or not, but this is literally everything you need to go down here and press the start streaming button and go have your very first stream on Twitch. If you do decide to go live for the first time, let me know down in the comments. It'll be super interesting to know. Again, make sure you subscribe to my channel, because a lot more OBS Studio and Twitch tutorials are gonna come in the future. This is gonna be a series where in the next video, we're gonna make this the same stream here look a little bit better, a little bit more professional. So that is it today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. GG.